Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. And if you're watching us on the replay, good evening, good afternoon, whenever you are here. And welcome to Coffee News Live, the fun morning show where you get to read along the coffee news with me and find out lots of information from local businesses and other people that may just have something to share. You can always be a guest on our show. And I am just about to put up the link if you're interested in being a guest. So if this is your first time here with us, I hope you have your coffee or tea. I have mine because I like putting my cinnamon sticks in it. You can get these really large, they're twice as like the 12-inch long cinnamon sticks from Bulk Barn. And if you're in St. Catharines, Thorold, and Niagara on the Lake, so you'll find your Bulk Barn. Okay, so if you do not know what the Coffee News is, it is the largest restaurant paper in the world. It is done by, published by many, many, many small business owners who deliver it to the restaurants. It has funny stories, jokes, trivia, and actually I can go grab one and show you what it looks like. Give me a second. There we go. Okay, should have had this beside me. This is what the Coffee News looks like. If you've never seen it before, this is what it looks like. And so when you go, when the restaurants all open up, you will see it again. And it has all the funny stories, all the trivia, local events. So you will see our online version because starting in COVID in April, we started going online with it because we couldn't deliver to the restaurants. So, well, I hope you enjoy. I hope you comment and tell me where you're from, what your favorite restaurants are, and all sorts of other things. So this is an engagement show. So I really do want you to participate. If you're watching online, we want you here. Okay. I'm just going to check a couple of technical things because I have to do all the things here. All righty. And we have several wonderful guests. Okay. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Here we're going to put up the coffee news and we're going to get going because we've got a lot to get through today. Lots of fun. The coffee news for August 10th. This year has just gone so fast. And yeah, I hope you're feeling good. I hope you're being safe and I hope you're still getting your taking care of yourself and making sure that you're good. And if you need help, you know where to reach out to. Okay, I'm gonna slide over here and we're gonna look at this week's coffee news is sponsored by Rachel from cleanwithbear.ca. Otherwise known as Mrs. Clean, and she's going to be on the show next week. So please stay tuned next week as well. So right now we're going to read Uphill Ride. A grandmother of six from Bolivia isn't afraid of a challenge. Mirtha Munoz is the oldest person to ever participate in her country's sky race. This race is entirely uphill. It takes place on the Death Road, so named for its dangerous 60-kilometer, 37-mile route from lowland to mountain peak. Oh, I wouldn't mind going the other way, but going up, not me. Munoz has been biking for many years, so did not think the race was a big deal. However, it's very different from the leisurely rides she and her grandchildren enjoy together. And I do have a picture of her. I'm just gonna go grab that and put it on the screen. Let's take this down and put this up. There she is. Wouldn't it be gorgeous? We have some gorgeous biking trails too. And August is the great challenge, the great cycling challenge. So if you're participating in that, I hope you are doing well and enjoying yourself. It's a little hot. Today's a little hot, but all righty, let's get through to our next story. And thank you to all of our wonderful sponsors. Please feel free to message them. You can always go to our page and read along with me. I'm going to type it in the comments here. It is stccoffeenews.com/online. So I'm going to put that in those comments. So you can, oh, there it is. Yes, when I did typing in high school, we learned how to not look at the keyboard and type at the same time. I'm not really good at it, but I'm passable. Okay, so if you wanna read along with me, that's where you wanna go. Okay, well, that's cool. I just learned something new. When I type a comment into this, it comes up for both YouTube and Facebook, because I am simulcasting and I have checked that we are broadcasting. So please, if you're watching, drop a comment in the comment section. I am going to pull back a bit here because I seem to be taking up an awful lot of space. Let's try not to do that. Okay, let's go to our next story. Cash giveaway. Some people living in a low-income district of Istanbul, Turkey, recently had something to cheer about. A mysterious man came into the neighborhood and paid off their debts. The man went into a grocery store wanting to know who owed money to the store. After asking to meet some of these folks, he came back to the store and paid their debts. The unknown man also placed cash in envelopes and put them on the steps of homes of families in need. When the grocery store owner asked, here is somebody there. We've got a guest and I can hear him. Yay. Okay. So I'm just gonna finish this story and a couple more. When the grocery store owner asked, but the man would say, suggested they could consider right. Robin Hood. Oh, wait, let's see. Now. And one of our other guests has arrived in the waiting room. It's like the screening room. In the theater, we used to call it a green room. Here they call it a staging area. So, all right. So our next story, I'm gonna jump right ahead here. Wouldn't that be nice though? But we've seen some of that generosity through COVID with people doing bags of groceries and things on people's, the ninja bags, right? My daughter got a ninja bag for her two kids. She's a single mom, and somebody there's a Facebook group apparently, and you post if you know somebody who's in need, and if you know their address, you do that privately. But there have been all sorts of really nice, generous things. This region is really awesome for that, and anybody who's participated in that, good on you. Okay. So the next story is the luxurious water house. Anyone wanting to live in a luxurious home, which is also a boat, can fork over $5.5 million US. Oh yeah, chump change. to build a floating, to buy a floating home called the Arco. It is set up like a real home, complete with living room, lounge, four bedrooms, a kitchen, and lots of windows through which to enjoy the ocean views. Available in Miami, Florida, it is perfect vessel for touring coastal waters. Although it is not built to travel in rough seas, it has rainwater purification system, solar energy, as well as hydraulic stilts, should the owner choose to raise it out of the water. So I did go and get the link for that because it was pretty amazing. So let's see if I can bring that up. I'm gonna hide this and put this in. Let's see. Let's see if it comes up. Did I miss any of it? This is the link that, oh, it's too long. So let's try it again. But you can, That's why I missed some of it. All right. Here we go. Trying one more time. We'll get to our first guest really quickly. And our first guest is actually an unscheduled guest. Our other wonderful guest is going to have to wait just a second. Here is the I'm going to show you this. And go. Look at this. Okay, so that's hardly our usual houseboat, is it? Pretty amazing. Okay, let's see if we have our last story here. We're going to get really quickly. Thank you to all of our advertisers, of course, of course, of course. I'm going to jump back here and throw the coffee news back in. And our last story, not the last of the coffee news, but the last story for everybody's talking. Clean water. In a city in Japan, colorful koi fish swim in the drain channels that border the streets. The city of Shimabara is located in Kyushu Island. The water is exceptionally clean in these drain channels because an earthquake that happened over two centuries ago, the quake caused freshwater springs to gush. In more recent years, city officials decided to stock the channels with the fish, which today are a tourist attraction. Shimabara is known as the city of swimming carp. There are only a few other towns in Japan with fish swimming in their drain gutters. So that's how clean their water is because it just gets flushed every time. Let's look at this gorgeous, gorgeous stream. So there's the gutter and see all the koi in it. Can you imagine having like fresh water? I don't know about, you know, getting water out of it for drinking and things like that. No idea. But their gutters are so clean that they can have these beautiful koi in it. All right. Taking enough time this morning. Want to get through everybody. And let's see, Christine, are you there? I cannot see her. Her picture. Christine, are you there? All right, I can't see your face. Is your camera on? All right, maybe we'll come back to Christine and chat to our first. Well, there we go. Our other guests. We have such great guests. Okay. We'll come back to you, Christine, because I'll let you figure out the camera thing. All right. And now let's see if we can bring on Wolf. Wolf is, Starchild, we were talking last week for the show that didn't work out. So he's come back to grace us with his wonderful presence and tell us more about his business. I hope we've got the sound issue worked out. Wolf, can you, no, still can't hear you. Let me see if I can hear you online, because that might be a thing. Yeah, no, we're not getting you. So, I don't know what's going on with the sound, Wolf, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up your website so that people can see what it is you do. And maybe you can work out something. I don't know what's going on. I can hear Christine, but I can't see her. I can see you, but I can't hear you. It's very odd. That's what live is all about. Okay, so bringing in the screen for alrighty. There we go. We're going to bring in Wolf's business here. Ooh, that might work out better. Let's see. And okay. Here is, I'm going to take myself out of here. So okay, I'm going to have to be here because people can't hear me. There's something. Well, I can hear.
Can you hear me all right?
Yes, I can.
Perfect.
Awesome. Okay, so now I'm going to move things around here and see if we can do this better. Yes.
All right. I did sort of figure it out on my end. I can, I'll talk to you about it after the show. There's like a setting on the screen you have to push to hit audio, I guess.
Okay. I'm going to let you tell us all about your lovely business and I'm going to duck out of the camera here. Whoops.
So good morning, everyone. My name's Wolf and I run an organization called Barefoot Bushcraft. You can see on the screen there. And we are the area's largest outdoor education center. We teach everything from archery to how to make sticks, how to make fire by rubbing two sticks together. We have a lot of children's camps, do a lot of children's programming. So basically, we teach everything to do with the outdoors. This summer has been a very challenging summer. We were closed most of the year. We just opened early in July 2020 with the whole COVID thing. But if you're interested in coming out, you can look at our website there on barefootbushcraft.com and you can book. Again, we have all kinds of different programs depending on what you're interested in. our number one feature is archery. We do a lot of like parties, so office parties, lots of office organizations come out. We have a 2-hour program where they do some axe throwing, knife throwing, card throwing, programs like that. And again, we used to run summer camp, but due to COVID restrictions this year, this is the first time in 8 years we haven't actually run summer camp. So I got into the business simply by, I was a teacher and there was no real jobs in the teaching field at the time that I started the organization. So I just sort of started thinking, well, you know, I want to be outside. I still want to continue to teach. So I got a bunch of jobs working at summer camps, places like YMCA camp, stuff like that. And it just sort of blossomed from there.
That's awesome. I absolutely love what you do. I'm going to switch this around so that it's more even. And now last week we had a chance to chat, but it didn't work out. The show was lost. So I wanted to ask you a few questions that I asked you last week. So I noticed on the website that you do wedding and bachelor and bachelorette parties.
That's right.
Tell me what those look like, because in Niagara,
sure, we
have a lot of people coming here to get married. And
lots of adventure. So what people do is they come out, usually the average bachelor bachelorette group is about 10 people. So they come out and then we split the group in half. So one half will go and do one set of activities, one half will do another. It gets quite competitive doing things like archery, axe throwing, knife throwing, stuff like that. And then we have like a special program where we have these rubber head arrows. So they're designed from archery tag originally. And if somebody gets a bullseye, we put the bachelor or bachelorette down range and follow some safety procedures, and then we get to shoot them, usually in the butt. And that's always fun, because sometimes people who come to our bachelor bachelorette party have been drinking before they arrive. So it makes the activities a little bit more exciting. And once we did have a bachelor who came, and he was a little afraid when they pulled the arrow back. And he tried to run away, but they still got him anyway. It was pretty funny.
Oh, that's awesome. That was my cat skittering in the back. Okay. Well, I want to thank you. We're going to have to do this again sometime. You're going to have to teach us something like from the skills that you have. But if you want to get in touch with Wolf, you can go to barefootbushcraft.com. So, Wolf, do you want to put that in the comments so that we can make sure people know how to reach you?
Sure. I don't know how to do that on this, but it is www.barefootbushcraft.com. And actually, our big program right now that we're very excited to reoffer this year is the Children's Archery Program. So that runs on Sundays from 1 o'clock till 3 o'clock, and it's only $15 to come out, and we provide instructors, targets, everything that you need, and that's for children 6 to 12 years old. So, and that's kind of like a drop-in program. People just show up, and they pay their money, we take debit, credit, all that good stuff, and of course cash.
What do you have in place?
I'm sorry?
Safety protocols for COVID? Do you have special things?
Oh, sure, absolutely. Yeah, because we're outside, we're really fortunate in that our restrictions are significantly less than most places because we are outside. So our standard safety protocols, if you want to wear a mask, wear a mask. I know there's a very large anti-mask community, so we respect that. It's like, as long as you keep your, keep your distances away from us, then, keep your 2 meters away, then that's fine.
Awesome. Awesome. And I can't thank you enough for coming back on the show. And we'll definitely have to do this again. So you take care and we'll see you next time.
And all right. Very much.
I'm going to try to get my networking group out to come and throw some axes.
That'd be a lot of fun.
All right. Take care, hon. Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay. Well, thank you, Wolf Star. Child, for coming on the show again. And such great fun. Gotta say, we've been out as a family before COVID and would do it in a heartbeat anytime. So I'm going to quickly do the next part of the coffee news. And our next guest is up in the staging area as well. So we'll read just a couple of things here because that's why we're here. Quotable quotes. Nothing endures but change. Heraclitus. And don't we all know that? Nothing endures but change. Change is a constant. Pretty weird. There is luxury in being quiet in the heart of chaos. I need that when I'm running the show and things aren't going well. I need that quote. Virginia Woolf, there is luxury in being quiet in the heart of chaos. Alrighty. I want to thank again our advertisers and partners. And we have several events. There's business networking. You can go to the website and check these all out. Options for care, long-term transitional self-help. And the Niagara Pumps House is having a fundraising auction. So don't miss that. I'm going to come back in the next session. Let's see who we've got waiting here. Christine, still can't see your video. Okay, I'm gonna let you. Oh, wait a minute. That's me. I can see me. Mute. I can see you in the staging area. So you yourself, right? So you. Is there a little asterisk above your camera view there that you see? Okay. What does it say on the top? Okay, and the top one is your internal camera? So I can only see it really small. So I'm gonna try to look a little closer at it. So that top one there, the video settings, what are the options? Oh, and are you using, which one of those is the one that you're using? Okay, give that a try. Is that the one you're in already? One, because it's not. That's okay, this happens. Try the camera. Yeah. That's very odd. See, okay, so go back to the other camera. And in your staging area, I do see, well, not yet. It hasn't switched back yet. Okay. All righty. Well, I'm going to bring you up on the show. I know you've got to leave. So I'm going to let you play with that for a bit, if that's because I have another guest waiting. And so we'll come back to you. You know what's funny, though, is I see you logged in twice. So I see your screen and I see another one that has you there, but it doesn't have your video. So work on the video and come back to you. All right. Hey, such is life. All right, we have another guest who was with us last week. And she is the wonderful lady who started the Toronto Women's Club. And she's going to chat with us for a moment or two. So I'm going to unmute her and bring her onto the screen. Cora Cristobal, welcome to Coffee News Live. I am so pleased that you were able to make it back to talk with us. So I'm going to let you explain to people what you do and why and how you came about doing it. Please tell us all about yourself.
Thank you very much, Gail. It's so nice to be back in your wonderful STC Coffee News. Good morning. And I'm happy to be here again and share a little bit of myself. I'm Cora Cristobal. I founded Toronto Women's Club so that I can help women get together and to empower women, right? And the way I empower women is I hold quarterly events. I provide education and training in the areas where women can be more powerful, more successful, and happier, and make more money, right? And with COVID, I still do events. I do virtual events. I provide coaching and mentoring. I do mastermind. I help people write a chapter in my book, and actually I'm just about to launch my seventh book in Amazon next week, which I co-wrote with Sunil Tulshani.
Okay, you're gonna have to help me with my book, definitely.
Okay.
Told me, have you written a book yet? And I'm like, no, I haven't, but I've been told I have to, so.
Yeah. That's wonderful. I can help you with that for sure. I will be happy to do that for you and for anybody who is listening. It's really extraordinary. It's a great achievement to be sharing your expertise, your wisdom, and the lessons in life. And we all have a chapter. We all have a book in ourselves. So it's good to share that to people.
I'm going to bring up the website for a minute so that maybe we can talk about some of the things that you do. So here's the website.
Yes.
And I'm going to switch things around here so that maybe we can see a little bit more of that. Okay. So you do consultations and people can book them online.
Yes.
Right. And speaking events. So how do people get started? Do they just contact you and... what happens?
Yeah, so for people who are interested to write a book, or they want to share a stage, they want to learn how to speak, how to write, or anything they would like to consult with me, put up a new business, quit their job, develop a new skill, develop a new habit, everything that pertains to the development of oneself to help to grow ourselves, right? They can go on my website and book themselves to a 30-minute consultation. So the website is torontowomensclub.ca, and that's how we are going to start, right? Because every person is different, and it is probably can be confidential in nature. So I would love to see you on a one-on-one consultation with me.
That's fabulous. And I see you have some pretty impressive friends there.
Yes, I have some high-profile friends like Grant Cardone.
Well, you're up there yourself, so, oh my word, you are such an inspiration.
And thank you.
You've helped so many women.
Yes, yes, and anybody can do what I have done. I am just an example, and if I have done it, anybody can also do it. And I can tell you how I did it, and I can share with you, of course. Of course, you need to take, everybody has to take action in order to do things, right? In order for you to do extraordinary achievements, you have to do also extraordinary work. But anything is possible. So that is just one I can tell.
You didn't come by this easy. This was...
Oh, no, it is not. No, it is not. Like I have pictures with Tony Robbins and Oprah Winfrey and Hillary and Bill Clinton. And I work for it for sure. It is not to brag, but it is just to show you or anyone that anything is possible, but you have to decide what you want to do in life, what you want to experience in life, because life is an experience. And if we grow ourselves, if we develop ourselves, we can also grow other people. And that's my philosophy in life. I grow myself so that I can grow other people.
You can't do it in a vacuum. So how important important would you say connecting and networking with, you know, other women who can support and help you be successful? How important is that to a small business person or a person who's just even thinking, I don't know if I can do this?
It is highly, highly, extremely important to be connecting with people, whether women or men, to connect with people who are more successful than we are, because that's how we learn. We are not only inspired, but we learn from them. How did they become successful? And this is exactly how I did it. I have been coached and mentored by the likes of Jack Canfield, Brian Tracy, Tony Robbins, and all these people. And now with the amount of knowledge and influence that I have, now I also become an influencer. So this is how we have a ripple in the universe. So it is highly important that you associate and hang out with positive people who can lift you up. And if I may say, let's avoid people who will pull us down, right? Because there are people who probably are limited in their knowledge and in their experience. And of course, I'd like to help people. I'd like to pull up people in the same way. We would like to be influenced by other people who have been more successful than we are.
So when you were a newcomer to Canada, this could you have foreseen this happening for you?
No. I never foresee this, right? Something's got to happen. Imagine something's got to happen in my life, because it is very normal that we have very limited belief in ourselves, and we thought those people are hard to reach. Who would? Yeah, like meeting Oprah Winfrey and all these famous people. I never dreamt of sharing stage with them or shaking hands with them, not even shaking hands with them or have picture with them. And yet, I was when I made one decision, which of course I have to get out of my comfort zone. I did not know that it will open up to more doors and more windows. And that's what happened. So it just means to say that there's really infinite possibilities in life, but you have to be open up your heart. You open up your heart and your mind to anything that is possible. It is infinite possibilities.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Cora. Mm-hmm. And I want to say to anybody who is struggling with their business or is being told you can't do this, you can't, Cora will encourage you and help you. Go onto her website, book that free consultation, and just take advantage of how wonderful this woman is and how much she can help you along in your journey. So thank you for being so encouraging to so many people, Cora, including myself, and I'm blessed to know you. So thank you again. We will talk again soon, and you've got an event coming up September 18th, right?
September 12th. It's going to be the first Science of Getting Rich workshop, September 12th. And when this is already live in Facebook, I'm going to post the link so that people can register in the link.
I will make sure we put it out there for everybody to see. Thank
all
you,
right,
Cora. Will you take care and have a beautiful day.
You too. Thank you so much. Thank you. All the best.
Cora Cristobal, the founder of the Toronto Women's Club. You can't get better than this. Her rise and story from her background and how she has succeeded in her life is very encouraging, and she's so generous to come on the show. So now we want to move on to the next part of our show, and this part is the part that most people absolutely love and are the first place that people go to in the Coffee News. Let's see if it'll decide to pop up for me, because sometimes I have to go backwards and forwards. All right, we have the trivia, the time you've all been waiting for. Let's get the trivia in here. Okay, if you know the answers to the trivia, What I want you to do is put the answers in the comments so that we can give you a prize. If you know the answers, try not to cheat, but you know, it is on our website. So an entertainer who performs in silence is known as what? You all know that. If you are disingenuous, are you quiet or insincere? That's trivia number two. Trivia question number three. What is the largest island of the Inner Hebrides off the coast of Scotland? I don't know that one. Trivia question number four. In children's nursery rhymes, who could eat no fat? Gee, that would be nice. That's my favorite part. I think I'm the wife. Yeah, you know who it is. Okay. Trivia question number five. Remember, drop your answers in the comments. Does honey ever go bad? Yes or no? If you know the answers to our trivia question, we have great big prizes that are worth around $100. So you want to enter the contest. And let's see what we've got next. Or who? Let's see. Have we got, we lost Christine. Well, let me tell you about Christine Malfries. While, even though she couldn't get in, we could hear her, but we couldn't talk to her. So I'm going to message her because we still have 15 minutes. So we still have time to get her on. So right now I'm going to show you her website because she's just, she does delicious things. Gotta say. And where did she go? There it is. Okay. Now you are, this is too good to have at this time of the morning because now everybody's going to want to go to her shop. And I know she has to leave to get to the shop in time to open up for everybody. Okay. So sharing this screen. You're going to hate me for sharing this because it's just so darn good. Let's see. Christine looks like he's coming back in. You know what, Christine? I'm going to let you talk about this because we can still hear you. You're going to be coming on in 2, 1, and boom.
Okay, I'm here. Can you see me at all?
No, but we can hear you.
Oh my gosh, I could see myself.
Oh, that's weird. That is so weird.
It is.
I don't know why. Let me bounce around here. No, not working for me. My apologies, but maybe we can try this again sometime and work it out in a
sure.
And figure out how it's and have you on again. But for now. For now, I'm going to put this, your website up, and you can talk us through your website and tell us a little bit more about you. Okay, so go ahead, please tell us about what you do and why you do it.
Okay, so my name is Christine Monfries, and I'm the proud owner of Monfries Rum Cakes, located at 4606 Queen Street in Niagara Falls. Wow, it's quite the journey. Prior to what I've done now, I was a TTC bus driver for 10 and a half years. And after the seventh year, I found it to be quite stressful. I no longer enjoyed the job. And what I wanted to do was really open up a bakery, which was my passion. I didn't want to wait until my retirement years in order to do so. It's something I really wanted to do like right away. And I received many messages from the universe. There are two sets of numbers that I saw on a daily basis, and those were 9/11 and 11/11. And every time I was thinking about my bakery, I ended up seeing those numbers. So whether it be the transfer on the bus, a license plate, a grocery bill, those numbers would just appear. And I said, you know what, this is more than a coincidence. These are definitely angel numbers. And this means I have to do what I need to do in order to be happy. So long story short, I quit my job in 2018. I moved to Niagara region from Mississauga in 2019, and I opened my bakery in June of 2020.
That is phenomenal. I'm looking at all these lovely, lovely cakes. and we met last year.
Yes.
Right? And you hadn't opened yet, had you?
I may have had a little storefront through the help of Spark Niagara. They were able to, you know, give me a little spot to sell my cakes.
Yes, and boy, are we glad for that. I absolutely love all these wonderful pictures. And these are real pictures, right? They are not like the setup with the plastic things.
No, they're real.
So this is the real deal, people. And I think everybody should make the time and go out and visit Christine. What time is the shop open? I know you have to run.
So from Wednesday to Friday, we're open from 11 to 5. Nice. And Saturday from 11 to 4.
Perfect. So you do Jamaican patties as well?
Yes. Well, we do sell Tinnell's patties, which are rated one of the best in Ontario. So I drive all the way to North York for those patties and bring them back to Niagara region. And they taste awesome.
Wow. So your website, I'm going to put it in the link, in the comments here so people can check it out. I'm just going to grab that website. And I want to thank you so much for coming on. What inspired you to do this?
It's something I've been doing as a side hustle for many years, and it's something I really enjoy doing. I got the recipe from my mom. I've been baking since I was about 10 years old. So it's been quite the hobby of mine, and I was just getting the urge in order to do this full time, and here I am. I don't regret it one bit.
So it's not just rum cakes. You've got a wide variety of things that you do at the shop, right?
So basically, it's mostly rum cakes and rum infused cheesecake cupcakes, and they come in different flavors, such as strawberry daiquiri, pineapple rum, Bailey salted caramel. We have about 6 to 7 flavors, and we alternate them every week.
Oh, I want to go now. But you're not there yet. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you got to make it out there, man.
Keeping you here. So do you do these as well? The, I've forgotten what, macarons?
No, we don't.
Okay. I love those too. But wow, you've got dessert bazaar. Is that a thing coming up?
That has already passed.
Okay.
Yeah.
All righty. So you can contact Christine. I'm going to run back. Oh, my word. That'll just this for words, gotta say. And there's Christine, although we can't see her live. This is you here.
Yes.
Let's see. What, there you are.
Yeah.
So I can say you kind of were here in the best ways.
Right.
And you're beautiful and you're successful. And how is COVID affected you a lot?
It affected my opening. I was scheduled to open April 1st, and I was like, oh my gosh, I can't sit at home. I got to do something. So what I did was I started delivering patties by the box throughout Niagara region for free, and people really appreciated that. So I got to meet people, and I got to drive through some beautiful neighborhoods. So, you know, put a smile on my face for sure.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to join me this morning. I know you've got to run. And I will definitely pop in as soon as I am able. I'm going to be tripping today. We're doing a little drive, but maybe tomorrow.
All right. Thanks, Gail. Looking forward to seeing you.
Dean, take care and have a beautiful day.
All right. You too. Ciao for now.
Well, Christine Monfries, fabulous, fabulous creative artist with rum cakes. So you want to do something special for someone special in your life? And not just special, they're always special. Make every day special. Go get a rum cake. Okay. Now that you've heard from three wonderful people who are all business people in our region. I mean, Cora, Cristobal, the Toronto Women's Club is not just for Torontonians. If you have things going on in your business that you need help with, Wolf Starchild, who runs a fabulous outdoor experience for families. If you're bored and you want to get your kids away from the screens, and then you want to come back and enjoy a lovely, lovely rum cake. We've got you covered. Coffee News is here. Okay, now let's get back to reading some more of the coffee news because we do only have 6 minutes left. All right, let's show this in the street. And our advertisers and partners love to hear that you found them in the coffee news. I know it's a little more challenging right now. Actually, it's a little easier to find the coffee news because you can just go to our website, download the PDF file, or you can watch the show and participate. And you can watch it on replay, which makes it even easier on YouTube and our Facebook page. Please share it with your friends so that they can enjoy the articles and information as well. One of our partners is The River, 105.1 Niagara, and 101.1 More FM for the different styles of music that you want to listen to. Fabulous people, and all in our neck of the woods, in the Niagara region, St. Catharines, Thorold, and Niagara on the Lake. Games, fun things to do. Take the time to relax. Take the time to look at the sky, look at out your window. There was a joke I read the other day about a woman criticizing her neighbor's laundry because the laundry was so dirty. Why was she putting it out on the line when it was dirty? And her husband just kind of said, well, maybe we need to clean the windows. So they cleaned the windows and she realized that the neighbor's laundry was not dirty. It was the windows, what she was looking through. So we can do that. Look at things. Make sure your view is clean and clear. Take a deep breath. Take some time for yourself, make some time for yourself, and you will feel better and relieve the stress. Coffee News is a great stress reliever. You can always go to Coffee News. Now we're in the exciting part of learning something new every day. Did you know? Big cities. India is the largest of the South Asian countries. It is also the most populous, with numerous big cities such as Delhi. I think here in Ontario we call it Delhi. In India, I believe it's Delhi. If you can correct me on that, because when I moved to Ontario, I thought Delhi was pronounced Delhi because that's what I knew India was. But Delhi, Mumbai, and Bengaluru. Nope, that was wrong. Bengaluru. Should have practiced before. But I like to be surprised. Did you know Play ball. The United States has a number of large football stadiums. These include Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum, in Los Angeles, California, MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey, and FedEx Field Stadium in Landover, Maryland. Big box. Did you know people from the Philippines who live abroad send balikbayan boxes home to their families? These boxes, which are inexpensively shipped by ocean cargo, are filled with such things as toys, clothing, books, and food. Did you know? The far north. The Earth's most northern region is the Arctic, the border of which is the Arctic Circle. It includes Greenland, Baffin Island, and the far northern parts of Canada, Europe, and Alaska. Oh, this one. I've seen so many shows on this one. Did you know? Smelly fruit. As soon as I saw smelly fruit, I knew exactly what they were talking about. Like blue cheese, durian fruit is smelly, or durian, another pronunciation thing. This large oval fruit has a shell that is covered with spikes, but the fruit inside is rich in vitamins and minerals. However, many people can't get past the disagreeable odor. Okay, those were our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things that may have been new information for you. Something to share with your family and friends. Something to quiz your parents on. Did you know? It's a good thing. It's something fun to talk about when you're visiting. On the lighter side, we have some jokes. An economist is an expert who will know tomorrow why the things he predicted yesterday did not happen today. Patient, I keep seeing spots in front of my eyes. Nurse, have you seen a doctor? Patient, no, just spot. What type of book has only characters and no story? A telephone book. He doesn't get lost. He discovers alternative destinations. That's me. That's me. What starts with E, ends with E, and has only one letter in it? An envelope. All right. So there are our on the lighter side stories. If you want to catch more of those in visuals, then please visit our Instagram, which is Niagara Coffee News, and our Twitter, which is STC Coffee News. And I'm going to post all of those links for our other social media in the comments. And I do respond to all comments. So if you love Coffee News and you miss it and you want to get it every week in your mailbox, when you go to this website, stccoffeenews.com/online, you will be able to scroll all the way down to the bottom here like I'm doing. And there is actually, I think I have to open this up a little more, and then it just does funny things. There we go. Then you put in your name and your email address, and you will get Coffee News every week into your mailbox. That doesn't mean you stop joining me here on the show, okay? So it's just a thing. I want you to be here, want your comments, want to answer your questions, want to find out where your favorite restaurants are and what things you like to do in COVID that keep you active. And so I want to say thank you for everybody joining me today. Wolf Starchild, Cora Cristobal, Christine Montfries, so honored to have you all on the show today. And you can watch the replay on YouTube and Facebook. Have a great day, everybody. And we will talk to you soon. And if you'd like to be on the show, please do not hesitate.